Hey guys, in this video we'll be going over Samos' hut. His hut can be found in Sandover Village. It resides on an islet to the south of the mainland. To reach the hut, you need to cross two bridges, one to a very small islet, then through a gate over the next bridge to reach the larger islet the hut sits upon. The gate you pass through has styling cues from Japanese torii. These are often found at the entrance to Shinto shrines, and passing through the gate is said to be the transition from the mundane to the sacred. This could be some symbolism, as Samos is the green eco-sage, and with that comes mystical-like powers and an almost spiritual-like connection to the eco, the life energy of the world. Or it might just simply be a nice decoration. When reaching the hut, you will first notice the size. The hut is much larger than the other huts in the village. The walls of this hut are made from bricks, like the foundation of the other huts, and is split into multiple sections. The roof of each section of the hut is made from hay. This is laid over wooden logs to create its shape. At the very top of the house is a lookout for Samos to watch over the world from. This has a small grass roof and some rope hanging down. Also, out the top of the roof is metal tubing. This looks like a chimney, but there is no fireplace we can see in this hut. In the wall of this top section are small openings. These go down into the middle section. Separating the top and middle sections is some wooden trim. The roof of the middle section have eaves that open up into the hut. There is also an opening with multiple trees growing out of. Notice these green rings, more on these later. Around the perimeter of the middle section, there is a deck that spans most of the way around it. At each end, there are a few pot plants and sacks. Over the doorway to the middle section hangs a lantern. This is attracting moths at night. In the walls of the middle section, there are four windows, two small glass windows, one of which is obstructed, however, by the pot plants and sacks. The other two are quite large and open with a hatch.
Hello, Blue Sage. Hello? Where in the blue blazes can he be?
To reach the middle section, there is a large ramp with a couple of stairs. This is constructed from wood and has a lantern hanging above. Underneath, they are storing more sacks, and a rake and hoe. The lower section is built on a wooden foundation. This also has a deck, but this one is very small, just to the side of the hut. At the end, we have more pot plants and sacks, along with a lantern above. The lower section has three small windows, more square in shape. Two just show an empty room at the back of the hut. The other one is Kira's bedroom. Outside the hut are lots of plants and rocks, large trees and small ferns. One very notable feature of this hut is the large windmill spinning in the wind. This windmill doesn't seem to be for powering anything. There is also a flock of birds circling Samos' perch at the top of the hut. To enter the lower section of the hut, there are two large garage doors. These are wooden and tilt upwards. In between these doors sits a lantern. Inside the hut, on the right-hand side, there is a large chest with a small bucket on top. In the corner, there is a table, two barrels, and a plant. On the back wall hang some of Kira's tools, three chisels and two hammers. These all seem far too large to be used, however. In the left corner, there is a shelf with three tiny buckets on top. In the nearby doorway sits a stool with another bucket on top. This bucket also has a chisel inside. Above the doorway is a lantern lighting this area. To the left of the doorway is another shelf with even more buckets. Below is another plant. In the center of the room hangs a crane system, used for moving Kira's inventions about. Hanging from this is the propeller for the Agrav Zoomer. Below this is a precursor transpad. This can be used to transport things to other pads found in the world. Next to this is a table with a hammer leaning against it. To the left of this is a wooden jig to hold the chassis of the Agrave Zuma. This is so it can stand up straight while Kira does her work on it.
We need power cells to fuel the heat shield.
Through the doorway into the bedroom, we have a blue mat. On the right-hand side, we have another bucket with two barrels next to it. On a shelf sits even more buckets. These buckets are incredibly small. Under this is another plant. In the corner is Kira's bed with three pillows on top. Above her bed, she has two shelves, both filled with books. To the left of the bed is a window, with the curtain hanging up on a slant. Next to this is a large chest. The middle section of the hut is Samos's area. To the left when entering, there is a lantern overhead. Next to this is a window with flowers inside. On the wall to the right of this, there are two large bookcases filled with books, and a table and stool. There is a large garden in the centre. The trees going out of the roof are planted here, along with some other plants. Behind the garden is a large window. To the right is the teleporter gate. This can connect to the other gates if they are turned on. Behind this to the right is another bookcase with five barrels and a bucket beneath. To the right of the bookcase is another window with a crooked curtain hanging up. There is a large tank in this hut. This is filled with green eco. This is then sent through the pipes to the plants. You can see it glowing in the rings around the plants and dripping from the pipes. This eco is sourced by the eco collector Samos has set up in Sentinel Beach. You can see grass growing along the pipes and in the places where the eco drips onto the floor. Next to the tank is a large carnivorous plant and a window behind it. Samos also has multiple blue mats on the floor. We also see the hut in Jak 2. In the opening cutscene, they are at the hut. They have also built a large runway into the rift gate.
As a sage of considerable years, I have known only one such great ordeal. Yet the hero it created was a champion for all time. Today's the big day, Jak. I hope you are prepared for whatever happens.
I think I figured out most of this machine. It interacts somehow with that large precursor ring. I just hope we didn't break anything moving it here to the lab.
Easy for you to say. We did all the heavy lifting.
Daxter, don't touch anything. Though the precursors vanished long ago, the artifacts they left behind can still do great harm.
Or great good, if you figure out how to use them.
I've had some experience with such things. I know you can make it work.
Looks like Jak still got the mojo.
Interesting. It appears to be reading out some preset coordinates.
Wow, look at that.
Finally, the last rift gate has been opened.
What are those things?
So this is how it happened.
You cannot hide from me, boy.
Do something, Jak!
What's this do? Or that? How about this one? Anybody press all the buttons?
In Jak 2, we are sent to a place called the Sacred Site to retrieve the life seed. This is where we learn that we are in the future, and the Sacred Site is Samos's hut. And Dead Town is the remnants of Sandover Village.
Scouts report movement in Dead Town. Creatures moving toward the sacred site, just as before.
What happened, before?
Metalheads broke through the old city wall. We fought them, but then the Baron pulled back, leaving everyone outside the new barrier to die. Only the Shadow stayed and somehow stopped the attack.
And now you expect us to go out there again?
You catch on fast. If you prevent the metalheads from reaching the sacred site, the Shadow will be most grateful. He might even ask to see you. Hey, I'm probably wasting this, but here's a Vulcan barrel for that pea shooter of yours. Believe me, you're gonna need it.
No, it couldn't be. That's not...
It's Samos' hut.
But what? How? When? Where? Why?
We're in the future, Dax. This horrible place is our world.
The shadows decided it's time to meet you.
Why is that place in the old ruins so important to you?
There's a powerful energy force at the old house. The metalheads are drawn to it.
No kidding. We used to know the guy that lived there.
I spent many a day cleaning up this place for old Greeny.
Good work, Jack. And Daxter, I suppose. Before we came through the rift long ago, I was nurturing that life seed from the great tree. It seems the metalheads are attracted to its power. Take the seed to Onin now. She will prepare it for Samos.
You mean you?
No, the other me, Daxter. My younger self needs the seed's power to become sagely.
So, let me get this straight. It's fair to say that by bringing your younger self the life seed now, we helped you become the sage you are today. We helped you get your powers in the first place. And you never thanked us?
Thank you, Daxter. Now go do it!
The eco-tank, pipes, teleporter gate, transpad, Kira's garage doors, all the way down to the pitchfork outside are still there, just decayed over all the years. The sacred site holds immense power and was contested over during the Metalhead Wars. The Metalheads were seeking out the power the life seed holds. But it is important to protect the seed. Without it, young Samos would not have been able to become a sage and nurture the seed in his old age so he can become a sage in his youth, after his older self stored the seed and over.
Samos told me to, you told me to, your older version, whatever. We heard you needed the life seed.
Yes. Its power will help me speak to the plants.
There he is! Roger, we're en route. I see him!
Jack, protect me from these guards! I must ask the plants vital questions about our future.
The name the sacred site also lends itself to the gate I talked about at the start, being a gateway from the mundane to the sacred. Samos' hut is an extremely important place. It has an incredible design and ties together critical points in the game. And that's my overview on Samos' Hut. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for the next one.